What are you doing? Minnie. What are you doing? Yeah, you're going kitty crazy. Yes, you're kitty crazy. Look at that. Yeah, you just walk right in front of mom's stuff. Okay, lay on my book. Yeah, rub on the computer. Yeah, get mad at it. Okay.
Hey guys, what's up? It's Marissa. I'm back for another BookTube video, and today I kind of just wanted to give you a wrap-up of everything that I've been reading lately and some of the readathons that I'm involved in, and also do an announcement video for another readathon that I just joined. So that makes three in the month of September. So the first one was the Zodiacathon, and that one was earlier this month, and it was only 4 days long. It was the September 4th to the 8th, and there was only four prompts for that. But I only ended up finishing two books. I ended up finishing a buddy read, and that was Carry On by Rainbow Rowell, and I ended up really liking that book. The first 100 pages, I was not optimistic. I just kept going, God, this is like exactly like Harry Potter. And I'm fairly sure that that's what the author was going for. She wanted it to be like very much like Harry Potter, and then almost like a comedy off of that. I don't know. It annoyed me. It really did annoy me at first, and I didn't really like it. I didn't really think I was going to get through it. So the fact that I finished it and I ended up liking it was a pretty big win for me. The next one was Read a Book Outside My Comfort Zone, and that I read Takeoff by Joseph Reed, and that I ended up really liking too. Surprisingly, the characters were engaging, the storyline was fast-paced, and it just carried you right along with it, and I ended up finishing that one fairly fast also, so really liked that. I unfortunately did not finish reading the other two prompts, so I kind of failed at that one. But it was pretty short. There was no way I was going to read four books in 4 days for that one. So the next one is the Hogwarts House Battles Readathon. And that one is all month long in September, and there are 16 different prompts that you can do, and you can double up on these prompts. I chose not to because I'm fairly confident I can get 16 books done. So right now I am actually more than halfway through. So I finished Circe. I actually just finished that on audiobook today. That was for the apparition prompt. I finished The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo for Arithmancy, and that one I also listened to on audiobook. I think I finished that one in 2 days. Circe and The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo, they were pretty good, and I know that people rave about these books. I didn't love them. They just weren't the books for me. So the next one that I finished was the History of Magic prompt, and that was The Hobbit. I also did that one on audiobook. So the next one that I finished, of course, was Muggle Studies, and that was Carry On by Rainbow Rowell. That was a double up from the other readathon. And again, I really ended up liking that book after the first 100 pages or so. And then the next one, again, was another double up, and that was the Potions prompt, and that was Takeoff by Joseph Reed. The next one I finished was The Transfiguration, and that was, I read Recursion by Blake Crouch. Ended up really loving that book. His book Dark Matter was really good too, and I don't know, he has these like sci-fi mystery, almost kind of thrillers that have great characters, and they have a great plot line, and they're like a mind-bending mesh of all these different things. Oh, they're so good. So good. And I'm not a sci-fi reader at all. I really have always detested sci-fi, but his books are just so good. So honestly, everybody needs to pick them up. So the next one that I finished was the Slytherin House Pick, and that was Wilder Girls. And I ended up hating that book. I mean, okay, I'm not gonna say hated it. I ended up really not liking that book because the ending sucked. It was like there was all this build up, and you get to know these characters, and I kept going, okay, when's the truth gonna come out? When is this mystery gonna be solved? What is going on? And then the ending just went meh. I mean, it was just like flatlined. Like, okay. Like almost like there was gonna be a follow-up story, but I'm pretty sure there's not. 7 books that I have finished so far out of the 16. We're not even halfway through the month, so I feel pretty good that I can get through the rest of these prompts. Those are all the books that I have read, and now I'm going to tell you about the books that I'm currently reading. Right now, I am currently reading The Aeronaut's Windlass by Jim Butcher. I am about, 50 pages into that. And the other one I'm in the middle of is Truly Madly Guilty by Leanne Moriarty, and that is a physical book that I just started the other day, and I am only about 25 pages into that. I kind of got a little bit bored, like I really wanted some fantasy, so I put that one down for a minute, and I picked up Romanoff by Nadine Brandis. That one, I am about 200 pages into it so far, and I really, really like it. I mean, the story's good. It's kind of gone on this, like, twist now that, you're just going to have to read the book, but it's kind of gone on this twist that is like, okay, where are they going to go with this? Because up till now, it's been pretty historically accurate, except for the, the paranormal element of it. So it's definitely been very interesting. Okay, so the last readathon that I am participating in this month is going to be is called the Fall Into Readathon, and this is being put on by Fight and Read Like a Girl and also the Library of Elizabeth. And I will go ahead and link their channels down below, as well as listing all the prompts for that. And this readathon is a 7-day readathon, and I believe it is the 16th to the 24th of September. So if you want to join that, go for it. I think it'll be cool. There are 6 different prompts for that. I know for a fact, especially because most of those days fall during the week, I'm not going to be able to read 6 books. So I went ahead and doubled up on some of these. The first prompt is a book that you read in school. And I don't have any of the books that I would have actually read in school, or I did actually read in school, so I am just going with a book that I read while I was in school that actually wasn't for school. So that is the Johnny the Homicidal Maniac, and that is a comic bind up. I'm pretty sure I showed it in one of my book haul videos. And then I am also using that for the second prompt, which is a DNF book. And I have DNF'd it. Kind of. I like put it down because I just didn't feel like reading it. So I'm going to try to get through that one for the first and second prompts. The third prompt is to continue on with a series. I don't have any series books that I have not, that I've read the first one, but I haven't read the rest of them. So I'm actually going to count Truly Madly Guilty by Leanne Moriarty for this, because it's by an author that I've read before, but I actually haven't read this particular book. So I'm just going to use that. And then the fourth prompt is a thriller, and that I'm going to do Sherlock Holmes by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. Don't know if that really counts as a thriller, but hey, you know what? It's open to my interpretation. So the fifth one, I am also doubling up with Sherlock Holmes, is a genre you don't normally read. Sorry for the cat, she's going a little nuts right now. Genre you don't normally read, Sherlock Holmes. Don't really read, just like modern detective novels. So we'll see how that goes. And then there is a group read book, and it's called On the Road by Jack Kerouac. I don't have that book. If I get some of these other prompts done, I may buy that book and attempt to finish it. I really don't know anything about it, so it should definitely be interesting. But yeah, I guess that is all the wrap up that I have for you guys today. And I hope everybody has a wonderful, wonderful reading month. I know I'm going to have a crazy wonderful reading month with 3 readathons, tons and tons of books to read. So yeah, have a great day, everyone.